Going on YouTube, it's your boy Curtis Seven here for another episode of The Seven Show. Now you're probably thinking, where are my two co-hosts today? What are they doing? They're not here with me. Yes, as you can probably see on screen right now, we're all there, but we're all not talking. And there's a reason for that. We filmed last night the whole Seven Show, had a great episode for about 40 minutes to an hour. Mate, got some controversial questions answered last night, but unfortunately, for uncontrollable reasons that were out of my hands, the audio did not work. So as you can see there, you can see us, but you cannot hear us, and I was so shattered about that, because that was an unbelievable show. So I thought, instead of leaving you guys stranded with no Seven Show this week, because it was such a big week in football, I thought, hey, I'll just do the show on my own, answer as many questions as I can, because a lot of you guys ask questions for the Seven Show on Facebook and on Twitter, and if you did ask a question, there's a good chance I'm going to answer it right now. So this show is probably not going to be as long as normal, but unfortunately, I just want to apologize, and for Chris and Negra as well. So anyways, let's get to the first question, lads. Now, we answered these questions last night on the show, so I'm going to give you the answers and pretty much what we all said about the situations, okay? This is from Josh Wallace. He said, thoughts on Southampton's start to the season? Will it last or will we see another mid-table slide? And I think we pretty much all agreed in the saying that Southampton's start to the season, even though it is fantastic, we can't see it being any other way than it's going to be another mid-table slide. But not mid-table as all the way down to, like, you know, 12th spot or something like that. We reckon they probably will get 8th spot, you know, just after the big teams, after clubs like Tottenham and Everton. I think Southampton will finish there. But good question, Josh. All right, this comes from Patrick Donald, and he says, who has been the best player in the Premier League this season? I think we all agreed, we all said Fabregas, Diego Costa, Di Maria. That was about it. They're the three main ones that we pretty much all agreed on this season. This comes from Navad Madai, who says, do you think Phil Dale was fair in the Chelsea United game? Good question. We all agreed. We all said, yeah, down the line, fair. Both clubs had decisions go for and against us. And, next question comes from Mark Sisk. He says, Victor Valdez or Andres Lindegaard for backup for Manchester United? And, to be honest, you know, we don't know much of Andres Lindegaard because we never seen him play. We see him a game here, a game here. You know, but it's been, honestly, it's probably been about a year and a half since we've seen Andres Lindegaard. So we don't know how he's going to go. At the end of the day, it's the backup. It doesn't matter. So if Victor Valdez wants to be a backup, we'll keep him. All right, next question comes from Pete. And he says, thoughts on West Ham and how they've started this season? We all said it's an unbelievable start to West Ham. We can't believe that West Ham are doing so good. You know, you just got to look in the summer. Everybody, before a ball was even kicked this summer, or West Ham fans anyways, wanted Sam Allardyce sacked. There was no way for him. I tipped him to be the first manager sacked, I reckon. I didn't think he was going to last this season whatsoever. But I tell you what, Sam Allardyce, he has made some crucial signings. Look at Alex Song, on loan from Barcelona. He was immense against City. Sacco, in goal-scoring vein of his life. He is just unbelievable at the minute. Inter Valencia, one of the best players at the World Cup. And look at him now, just shining for West Ham. These summer signings that Sam Allardyce brought to West Ham has just proven quality, and results are showing. So fair play to Sam, fair play to West Ham. Good on him. Next question comes from Samuel, and he says, how did each of you end up supporting your club? Now, this is a great question. Now, I'm not going to speak for the boys, for Chris and for Edgar. To be honest, this is such a good question, Sam. I'm actually going to answer this question next week on the next Seven Show, so we could all give our answers there, because there was some top answers from Chris and Edgar as well. So they're the questions that we answered on the show as well. But I'm going to go on Facebook right now. I'm going to answer pretty much nearly everyone's questions, whether they be good, whether they be stupid or not. So first question comes from Adnan I can't even pronounce your name, Led, but you'll know who you are. What if one Mata was sold in January, the transfer window? Which player do you think Louis van Gaal will bring into the club? I don't think one Mata will be sold in January, first off. And if one Mata was to go, we'd probably get a defender, you know. So I'll probably say, you know, we'll sell Mata and buy a defender. Unless one Mata goes to the Juventus and we could get Vidal still. But other than that, I think we'll definitely be a defender. What do you guys think is the missing link for the Man United squad? I'll hold back four. Nah, I'm only joking. what's the missing link? I still reckon we need that defensive midfield position. Don't get me wrong, Fellaini's been immense, but he's been immense because he's been pushing forward. I don't think he could keep up this momentum the way he's going at. I still think the missing link is not in the defense, is actually in that defensive midfield position. Like I said, if we get Vidal, that would be the missing link. Yes, we could get a better defense, but I don't think a defense is the missing link, you know. But don't get me wrong, defenders would be handy, you know. Come over Mats Hummels, you know what I mean? All right, now this comes from Usman, who says, Curtis Seven, we don't have a pacey player on the wing and up front like other teams like City, Chelsea, Arsenal, and Spurs. What do you think we need, or do you think we need any pacey players? Mate, I think you're forgetting the fact that we have Angel Di Maria, mate. He is probably one of the paciest wingers in the Premier League. It would be nice to have a few more pacey wingers, don't get me wrong, but I don't think it's an urgent matter. I don't think it's what we need. I think you play too much FIFA, my friend. But, nah, Angel Di Maria. You can tell he creates stuff on the wing. And that's pretty quick. He ain't that slow. Plus, we've got players on loan like Zaha with a better pace. Yeah, and as much as Antonio Valencia is frustrating at times, he's one of the quickest players in the Premier League. So, I don't think we're lacking pacey wingers. All right. Next question comes from Wallard. He says, what player you most want in the Man United squad? I think I've already covered that in Arturo Vidal, or that type of player anyways. This comes from Callum Richardson, who says, do you think Louis van Gaal should bring... Oh, who do you think Louis van Gaal should bring into the club and get rid of White? Like I said, I think Louis van Gaal should bring in that defenders, that midfield position... and get rid of, I think, that's a good question, get rid of players. I think players who aren't going to make it now, you know, Anderson, you know, he's not even going to get a game. Players like this, I think, yeah, it's going to be tough, because if we make Champions League next season, we're going to need a bigger squad, so it's going to be such an interesting perception on who we get rid of, you know, because I like to see players like Nani, you know, and Wilfred Zaha get another chance at United. As for Tom Cleverley, I don't know. We're going to see how the season goes for Tom. I don't think his career is finished at United whatsoever. So, all right, next question comes from Josh. He says, what did you think of the game against Man United Chelsea? We covered this a lot in the 7 show last night. We thought it was a good game. We all agreed saying that Man United did not deserve to lose whatsoever. Definitely deserved a point. It was a great game, great spectacle. One game that everybody was expecting Chelsea to dominate and Man United to not even get a sniff. But we proved everybody wrong that we weren't just mugs for this game. You know, we stood up to the challenge and deservedly so, we got a point. So definitely played well. Shocked a few people, I would say. All right, next question. This comes from Pavel, who says, what we need in January without Hummels. I think I've covered that, that midfield player. This comes from Zach Davies. He said, if De Gea leaves, who would we bring in? Oh, mate, that's Victor Valdez. He's already in training with Manchester United. But no, seriously, I don't want to think about that. I do believe De Gea will go in sometime in the next few seasons to Real Madrid or Barcelona or some Spanish side, but we'll cross that bridge when we come to it. For now, he's ours, all right? Zach asks another question. What should Louis van Gaal do with Nani once his loan expires? Apparently, I haven't been following the Portuguese league too much, but all I do hear is that Nani is tearing it up. He is absolutely on fire for Sporting. And if that's the case, if he really is on fire and getting his confidence back up and he wants his career, wants another crack at it, I'll be more than happy to bring Nani back to Man United just so we can have another crack. Definitely bring him back for a season, give him one season at United, and if he's not cut it then we should cut ties with him. Alright, now, next question is from Alan Kenny, who says, will Southampton finish in the top six? We've already covered that. We all reckon that they won't finish in the top six, even though they're having an unbelievable season. We all pretty much agree that they're going to finish around 8th spot, which is unbelievable for them. Nobody would have picked that at the start of the season. All right, next question is from Ben Yap. Do you think we will bring Arturo Vidal into the club? Looks like Van Gaal is trying 4-2-3-1 with two holding midfielders in the last match against Chelsea. Quite a solid defensive line. Your question is, will we bring Vidal into the club? It's going to be very, very difficult. I don't think that could happen. But you never say never. To be honest, I don't think we're going to sign Falcao or Di Maria. So we sign them, so you never know. That 4-2-3-1, that seems to be working. It seems pretty solid. If that's the case, mate, Arturo Vidal, I'd welcome him straight into the starting 11. So, good question there. All right, next question is from Nick. He says, if you could have any two players ever in their prime at your preferred club, which would it be and why? If you could ever have any two players in their prime, Cristiano Ronaldo at your preferred club, Cristiano Ronaldo and... That's a difficult question. There's so many players. Well, I'm just going to say Cristiano Ronaldo and David Beckham, my two favorite players. All right. Do you think Fellaini deserves a second chance? Didn't even realize he had a second. Didn't realize he was on a second chance ban. Definitely, this is his first chance, and yes, he's taking. He's just been in such good form lately. Hopefully it continues. He was injured at the start of the season. That's why people are thinking that, does he deserve a second chance? All right, next question's from Mark. Will Chelsea remain unbeaten throughout the season? If not, who will beat them? That's a great question. I don't think the unbeaten team like Arsenal did with the Invincibles will ever happen again. I do think Chelsea would be beaten this season. Who will beat them? I do not know. I don't know who will beat them, but if they were to lose, I would say it would be to a team like nobody's expecting, like West Brom or something like that on an off day. But if any team was to beat the Invincibles of Chelsea, of Arsenal, it would be this Chelsea team. They definitely could do it. Do you think Phil Dale was fair? We've already answered that one. We all agreed on that. JJ Silva Jr. asked, did Man United pay the ref? Ha ha, buddy. All right, next question is Mark Brocklybank. How long do Louis Van Gaal will be the manager as long as he's not fired? Well, he signed a 3-year deal. I think he will stay for the 3 years. I'm not too sure if he would extend that 3 years. Definitely, I reckon he will definitely manage out the 3 years. This comes from Derek. Do you think United can come in the top four? Definitely. Next question is from Matthew Vickers, who says, do you think that the draw with Chelsea will bring confidence? Definitely. Definitely. Don't get me wrong, I think we could probably lose to City this week, being that, City are unbelievable at the at Etihad. And our season's going to be very inconsistent, as I said on previous episodes, that... we're going to have these great results, but then we'll just lose the next week. That's just the way this season is going to plan out. We're rebuilding, and you got to expect this. So, yes, this will give us confidence. I'd love to see us grow to the Etihad and get a win, obviously. But, even a draw is unlikely. So, I wouldn't be surprised if we lost. Good question. This comes from James. Do you think Cristiano Ronaldo will come back to Man United? I doubt it, mate. I doubt it. I'd love to see it happen. I just doubt it. This comes from Desley. Who do you think dominated in the game and why? I think it was 50-50. I think we were better in the first half against Chelsea, and I think Chelsea were better in the second half. So I don't think anyone dominated. Even in that second period when Chelsea scored, they just had no intentions of scoring another goal. They just bossed the ball. They just kept possession. They probably dominated a little bit more than us, but I wouldn't say they dominated us with intentions to put, you know, four or five past us. So I would say that game was 50-50. This comes from Ben. Man United, man of the match against Chelsea. Marouane Fellaini, definitely. All right, next question is from Matt Johnson. Who is the most underrated player making the biggest impact for Manchester United? Two players for me. Underrated, it's going to be Daley Blind and Ander Herrera. Those two, you just don't see them that much compared to, you know, Falcao and Di Maria. But boy, they make us tick. Those two players, especially Daley Blind and Ander Herrera as well, both in their own ways. They are both sublime signings for us this season. All right, next question's from Jack. Do you think Louis van Gaal is the world's greatest manager? No, unfortunately, Jack. Alright, next question's from Sammy Pitts. If you have replied to this, okay, no worry about it. Alright, next question. Siddulk? I think I've got your name wrong there, sorry buddy. Do you think Fellaini will be in form again? He already is, mate. Next question's from Ricardo. Next question's from Isaac. Do you think Fellaini, Young, Cleverley would be useful? Yeah, definitely, mate, definitely. If there's one thing I've noticed about Louis van Gaal, compared to David Moyes, Louis van Gaal is getting the best out of these mediocre players. Or let's just say they were good players under Fergie, they were mediocre under Moyes. Now players like Fellaini, Ashley Young, you see Ashley Young in preseason, even in a few games this season, he's been alright, he's been pretty good. So Louis van Gaal, if there's anybody who can get the best out of players, it's definitely Louis van Gaal. So yeah, that could be useful. Alright, next question's from Ben. Do you think that players like Fellaini, Young, Lingard will be sold? Pretty much the same question, funny enough, so I won't answer that one. Alright, the last question comes from... I can't pronounce that, buddy, so go on Facebook, have a look. Will you think Nani will be there at the start of the season? Like I said before, I would love to see Nani there at the start of next season to have another crack at his Manchester United career. Whether that happens or not, I'm not too sure. I'm not too sure whatsoever. I hope so. I like Nani. I really think Nani is a great player. Was just definitely, definitely lacking confidence. Don't ask me why. He's got the ability to get past players and, you know, and score goals. But for some reason, just lacking that confidence. But hopefully he's finding his form at Sporting, which I think he is. And if you could bring that back and have another crack, well, mate, bring it on. But anyways, lads, that's going to wrap up this short 7 show. I really apologize for that. If you want your question answered, lads, for the next 7 show, make sure you follow me on Facebook and on Twitter. The link is in the description. That's where I got all these questions from there. So thank you very much for answering these questions, asking these questions, shall I say. So so follow me on Facebook and Twitter, hashtag the 7 show, the 7 army. You guys are fantastic, and once again, guys, I apologize for the podcast / the 7 show being half cancelled. Anyways, it was a ripping show. We asked a lot of questions, and don't forget to get your questions for next week. We're gonna have the Manchester derby. Don't forget, get questions for Edgar, get questions for me, and get questions for Chris as well, who's a massive Liverpool fan. So, you know, surely there's a lot of questions you can ask all of us. Even though we did answer a lot of Mario Balotelli questions for Chris last night, maybe you guys might want to ask those questions for him next week. But until then, people, I will catch you next week. Anyways, I'm your boy, Curtis7. Thanks for tuning into the 7 Show. Take care and peace.